Hello again to our evening, no, not evening, afternoon session. I'd like to welcome Christian. He is working as network engineer at SIS 11, and he will explain us how to automate the ripe DB handling with NetBox. Please, the stage is yours.
Yeah, thank you for your introduction. Yeah, thank you for joining my talk. My name is Christian. I'm a network engineer at SIS 11, and one of my interests is in network automation. So let's talk about what you can do with NetBox and the ripe database. Yeah, depending on your size, you are dealing with hundreds or even thousands of prefixes in your organization, which you hopefully have documented well in NetBox. In addition to that, there are all these interesting ripe policies, which we all love to comply with. So, of course, this is how your objects in the ripe database look like, right? Or is it more like that? Yeah, let's face it, keeping the objects up to date isn't much fun. At least from my perspective, manually updating those objects is tedious work. It's likely to have an inconsistent and outdated database. Yeah, what can you do about it? Yeah, we have looked around and discovered those two APIs. NetBox, that supports webhooks, which is simply an HTTP request sent to a predefined URL whenever you update, modify, or delete an entry in NetBox. And the RIPE is offering a database, the RIPE database is offering an REST API as well. So let's simply put the URL of the RIPE database API into a NetBox webhook. Problem solved. Yeah, but then this happens. It's great to have all your data in NetBox, but the RIPE database expects some additional information, like admin handles, abuse handles, and so on. So how can we bring these two together? Yeah, obviously a middleware is needed to translate the NetBox webhooks to RIPE database AP calls. So by the way, this is an actual picture of us, how we looked developing the middleware. Just kidding. So this is our result, and we call it RIPE Updater. Our goal was to support several features like, most importantly, inetnum and inext6num object automation on creation, update, and deletion. We also want to validate all requests to filter out unwanted prefixes, for example, RFC1918 addresses you don't want to push into the RIPE database. And handling of overlapping inetnum objects is also important because you cannot have overlapping inetnum objects in the RIPE database. Yeah, in addition to that, we want to add data-based data like the abuse handles and so on. So these should be added based on templates, which you can simply select in NetBox. Just to make sure, backups of old objects should be created before deleting or overwriting them. And last but not least, logging and mail reporting is important to keep track of things going on. So what do you need in order to run this? Of course, you need NetBox version 2.4 or later, but I hope you don't have such an old version running anymore. You have to add some custom fields to NetBox. On the other, you have to add, for example, a RIPE report, which is a Boolean. So you can just to determine if this object should be present in the RIPE database or not. And you need to add a drop-down list, a RIPE template, which you can select the template on this prefix should be processed on. You know, and of course you need RIPE database access with a maintainer password. And I wish, just a wish from my side, I could authenticate to the RIPE with an API token, because then I don't have to put the maintainer password in my tools. Genau, and the platform to run this on, you need as well, of course, and we have chosen Docker for that. So let's go through what happens if you create a new prefix in NetBox. I want this prefix to be present in the RIPE database, so I have set a RIPE report to true. And I can now select a matching template for this prefix. Once you have clicked on create, several things will happen. At first, the network is sending the webhook to the updater as a POST request. The RIPE updater is then reading the selected template from the local file system. To check for overlaps, a quick search in the RIPE database is performed, and if an overlap is found, the overlapping prefix will be looked up within NetBox. If the overlap is not found in NetBox, which we consider as single source of truth, the a backup of the overlap will be stored in S3 storage, and then the overlapping prefix will be deleted from the RIPE database. It's most likely that's an outdated entry. So finally, the new prefix is then added to the RIPE database. Yeah, and to let you know what happened, you will receive an email notification with all the details. So let's recap. Yeah, you will now have a consistent and always updated RIPE database. You can now focus on your important work, like perfecting your espresso. But one question remains. Why am I telling you all this? I'm very happy to announce that we are planning to release the RIPE updater in the first quarter of next year. If you want to keep track of this, you can already watch the displayed repository. I hope you find this useful and thank you for your attention. Do you have any questions?
Yeah, thank you very much for that talk. There's indeed one question. How can you make sure that your probably perfectly written automator doesn't go crazy and pushes a lot of interesting information into the RIPE database? Yeah. Is there any kind of lock or something?
There is no lock, but do you mean lock or log from logging? I would recommend. If you don't have it today, I would recommend that you set the notify, which is an email address, to all your objects in the RIPE database. So you will receive an email notification whenever an object is modified from RIPE. Yeah. If you don't have it yet, please do it. It is great to keep track of things going on.
Okay, perfect. Second question would be, does it only update inetnum and inet6nums or any other objects?
Currently only inetnum and inet6num objects are supported, but yeah, this is, yeah, maybe we can add some more objects in the future.
Okay, and then the last question, is there also support for other databases like RRDB support, or is it like IRS agnostic only for RIPE?
At the current state, it's only for RIPE, but this is a thing we will have to consider in the future, yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, and thank you for open sourcing it. And hopefully all of our audience will keep track of the repository, and then we'll use it in the next quarter.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.